ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في سلطانه ولا مناوئ له في عزته وجبروته وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وقائدنا رسول الله محمد اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي يا رسول الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the creator, he is the provider, he is the sustainer. And we be witness that there is no God but Allah. And we be witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. We are sending our blessings and our salutations to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to his entire house and all the companions and also to the followers of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear respected brothers and sisters, welcome to this gathering in the masjid, and especially when it comes to the Jumu'ah, it is one of the special days for the Muslims ummah. And when we gather to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we seek the pleasure of Allah, we have always to purify our intention, that we didn't come as a habit, as a tradition, but we came to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and we came to show gratitude to Allah that He gave us another chance to witness another Jumu'ah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith, مَا بَيْنَ الْجُمُعَةِ وَالْجُمُعَةِ, between the Jumu'ah and the other Jumu'ah. So it means that you get the blessings of Allah to attend the last Jumu'ah and to come again for another Jumu'ah. So it's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let's move quickly to the topic that I wanted to share with you. It's so important to know that every time of this year, every time of the same year or the same time at each year, everyone start to look towards his direction, to Al-Kaaba, because we will have at that time and also in the next time we will have many people are going to Hajj, and we will start inshallah listen to the talbiyah, labbaik Allahumma labbaik لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك, and everyone will show his love and kindness to this house, and we will find many people having that kind of sense and kind of passionate to go and do Hajj and perform Hajj. That is why we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the beginning to let all of us inshallah next year amongst the people who are doing Hajj inshallah. So let's go to the beginning, how it started and who built Al-Masjid Al-Haram. Main questions we have to know before the time of Hajj inshallah, and we have to think about the wisdom why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose the sacred house in this land, in this position actually. And when it comes also, who built the masjid, who built the sacred house, all of us right now we are sitting in the direction of Kaaba. When we stand for prayer, we pray towards Al-Kaaba, towards the sacred house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But how it is started? We know exactly that Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salam, by his time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the permission to marry another woman with his first wife, Sarah. So he married after Sarah, he married his next or his second wife, which was. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the command to take Hajar after the pregnancy, after delivering the baby. Allah gave him the command to go and choose for him the spot of al-Masjid al-Haram. But let's move first to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, and this hadith is authentic one, when Abu Dharr al-Ghifari came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, Ayyul masajidi wudi'at awwal? What is the first sacred house, or what is the first house on the earth? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Masjid al-Haram, the sacred house. And he said again, what is next? What is number two? What is the masjid number two has been built? He said, Al-Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem. And Abu Dharr al-Ghifari asked the third question, how long between the two buildings? What is the period of time between that building and that building? He said 40. And here is the scholar said that he sallallahu alayhi wasallam meant 40 years. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also in the Quran said, Inna awwala baytin wudi'a lin-nas, the first house has been built ever, lalladhi bi Bakkah, which is in Bakkah. And we before explained the word Bakkah, it comes from the crowdness, and it comes also, the word Bakkah means it breaks the necks of the tyrants or the oppressors who wanted to do something bad against that sacred house. That is why this house, under the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and some people also said one of the names of Mecca, you can say it also Bakka. So this is the first sacred house has been built ever. Has been ever built. And here is some of the interpretations, some of the opinions of the scholars who said that the angels of Allah came to the earth and they built the sacred house. Another opinion said that Adam alayhi salam was the first one who built al-Masjid al-Haram. One of the opinions also said that Nuh alayhi salam came to this land and he built al-Masjid al-Haram. But what we are sure about, that Ibrahim alayhi salam was also one of the people who raised up the foundations of al-Masjid al-Haram. And we will come to the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, but let's go, because we will have many benefits and many lessons that we can take in our daily life. It happened long time ago, but nowadays we need some of the Muslims to know more about the lessons that we can extract from the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. So Ibrahim alayhi salam took his wife, the second wife, Hajar, and her son Ismail, and they went to the spot of al-Masjid al-Haram. And he didn't raise the foundation yet. And when he went over there, he just has a bag of date and a leather bag of water. So when he went to the spot and he traveled with Hajar and Ismail, he left them. And he turned his face wanting to go back to Sarah. But at that time, Hajar didn't realize what's going on, didn't realize what's happening. And she started to ask him, "Ya Ibrahim, where are you going? Where are you going? Why are you leaving us?" And Ibrahim didn't reply. She many times followed him, "Ya Ibrahim, where are you going?" And he didn't reply. It seems that there is something, there is kind of order came to Ibrahim, and he didn't reply. And now she started to figure out, now she started to realize what's going on. And she told him, "Allahu amaraka bihada," has Allah commanded you to do this, to bring us to this desert? There is nothing in this desert. And at that time, Ibrahim replied and said, "Yes, he ordered me to do this." And here is one of the lessons. Hajar, what's the first statement? She didn't speak badly with her husband. She didn't tell him, "Why are you bring here? Why you bring us here? How we will live?" But the first statement, when she realized that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the command to leave them at that spot, she said, "Idhan falayyudayyana." Indeed, he will not forsake it. He will not abandon us. We will not be forsaken. But still, Allah will protect all of us. He will not leave us alone. Ibrahim alayhi salam turned his way and he directed himself to the place of Sarah, the first wife. At that time, Ibrahim alayhi salam made a dua to Allah. And all of us, alhamdulillah, we know this dua. "Rabbana inni askantu min dhurriyyati biwadin غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون." Oh Allah, I have left part of me, some of my offspring, in that spot, in a desert. There is nothing at all in this desert. Oh Allah, I left them to establish the prayer. لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. The first reason why I left them, number one, to establish the prayer. And it gives us the hint about the importance of the salah. The importance of the daily salah. رَبَّنَا. Oh Master, I left them to establish the prayer. فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِرَةً مِّنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ. Oh Allah, let some groups of people go and share the life with them and live with them. So how can you convince some of the groups of people to come and live in a desert and which has nothing at all? But he made the dua and he said, "Oh Allah, grant them, give them some of the fruits, some of the food, so they can handle this issue and they can live and they can survive." And he turned away Ibrahim alayhi salam. He went to Sarah, he stayed over there. But let's go to Hajar. And now Hajar, literally alone with her baby, nothing at all. Can you imagine? Can our sisters in the back imagine if she is alone in a desert and she has nothing? She has nothing at all, just some dates and some water. And she started to eat and nurse feed her baby. But subhanallah, after a short time, the food already finished, and she didn't find anything to feed or to drink, even herself and her baby. And now, this is the nature of the mother. She started to search for something to eat and to feed her baby. And all of us know this very well, that Ismail alayhi salam started to cry time after time. And we know very well what happened to the heart of the mother when her baby started to cry. She was afraid that he might die. He might die out of hunger. And she started to walk, first walk, searching between As-Safa and Al-Marwa, the two mountains. She started to walk, then she started to run between As-Safa and Al-Marwa. For seven times, she's going forth and back. But subhanAllah, at that time, she didn't know anything that the miracle will happen. But this is the heart of the mother. She went walking, running. Imam Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says, فَذَاكَ سَعْيُ النَّاسِ إِلَى يَوْمِنَا هَذَا. This is the source of the sa'i between As-Safa and Al-Marwa that we are doing still right now. Subhanallah. Still, till now, we are doing sa'i. We are following the footsteps of the mother Hajar. And do you know what? At that time, she came back to discover that there is something happening. And she started to hear something. Something happening. And when she got the voice and she listened, she heard something, she said to herself, Sahin. Sahin means listen. Wait. Keep listening. And she found the water coming out from the ground under the feet of Ismail alayhi salam. In another narration that Tabarani mentioned, that she saw the angel Jibril alayhi salam digging the land with his wing, and he digging the well of Zamzam. But let's go to the authentic narration that she came back and she discovered the water came coming out from the land, from the ground. And she came with the leather bag. She wanted to accumulate. She wanted to gather some of the water to save it to her baby and herself. And she started to say, Zimmi, Zimmi, means come together. Come together. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Rahimallahu Umma Ismail. May Allah shower Hajar with his mercy. لو تركت ماء زمزم, if she left the water and she didn't gather it, لصارت عينا معينا, it will turn to a long river. But she wanted to gather it. And subhanAllah, something happened in this area and it became a huge well. And can you imagine, like 100 years ago, till now, people are taking from that well, from that blessed water. And when you take it, when you drink some of this water, with the intention, with any intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you what you intended for. And this is the blessings of Zamzam. This is the barakah of Zamzam. At that time, Hajar realized that there is something going on, and her baby will do something in the future. People started when they saw the water, and you know, when you have the water, it means you have life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وجعلنا من الماء كل شيء حي. Every human or every single soul we created out of water, because of water. So the water is the source of the life. That is why the grass started to appear on the desert. People started to come, they found the water, they started to build houses. And this is what Ibrahim alayhi salam said in his dua, فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً. Just make the hearts of people, their hearts, go for that place. What does it mean? It means they will be so sensitive, will be so passionate, so kind towards this place. And you will notice this. You notice this. Even if you didn't go to Hajj, by the time of Arafah, by the time of Hajj, you will find all of us, or most of us, are crying. The tears, you know, will come down. Why? We are missing the house of Allah. We are missing the sacred house. We need to go Hajj. Even if you didn't go before, you will have this kind of emotion towards the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً. Make their hearts shake, tremble, out of happiness, enjoyment, out of missing towards this sacred house. And this is what happening. If you went to Hajj before, if you went to Umrah before, I'm sure by the day of Arafah or by the time of Hajj, you will find your heart different. Why? You have been attached with this house. You have been attached with the Kaaba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what happened next? How Ibrahim returned back to Hajar and Ismail to fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will speak about that inshallah the second khutbah. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let all of us go for Hajj inshallah next year. Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allahu khayra. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-aliyy al-azim li wa lakum. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. ثم أما بعد, dear respected brothers and sisters, and as we know that Ibrahim عليه السلام, when he returned back to check out what happened to Hajar and to see what happened to Ismail, and he found large number of people started to gather and started to come to visit and to live with Hajar and Ismail. At that time, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he got the command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to build the house. But for our young ages, for our sons and our daughters, they have to get that lesson. It's so important. Listen to this, please, carefully. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he got the command to build and to raise up the foundation of the house, he didn't tell Ismail about the command of Allah. He brought him and he said, "Oh my son, I have a command from Allah. Allah gave me order." And he didn't tell him what kind of order. So what? We have to fulfill the command of Allah. And he said, even without knowing what kind of command, he said, as long as Allah give you a command, we have to obey. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This is the pious, this is the religious son. He always cares about what Allah said. And this is Ismail. And please, think about this. Who raised Ismail up? Not Ibrahim. Ibrahim used to just come and visit them. But Hajar. Hajar raised him up. And she taught him how to obey Allah and how to obey his father. She didn't tell him, your father left us and went to his other wife. Your father left us long time ago without giving us money, without giving us food. She didn't tell him any bad ideas about his father. And this is also one of the messages to our sisters in the back. Always speak nicely about your husband, especially in the presence of his children. Don't let them think bad about their dad. And this is one of the issues, how to build the Muslim house and how to build the Muslim community. So Ismail alayhi salam said to his dad, you have to fulfill the command of Allah. You have to obey Allah. Ibrahim said, وَتُعِينُنِي, will you help me? He said, for sure, of course, I will help you. And then he told him, إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَنِي أَنْ أَبْنِي لَهُ بَيْتًا. Allah, give me the command to establish, to raise the foundation of his house. And they started together, Ibrahim and Ismail. Ibrahim, he used to put the bricks together, and Ismail used to give, to hand it to him. And subhanallah, they prepared together until they finished the building, the house of Allah. Allah says, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Allah. So they built the house of Allah, and the first dua they said, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Oh Allah, accept from us. And just to show the humbleness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have some brothers, when they come to Jumu'ah, when they come just to pray two rak'ahs, they think that they did something huge and Allah has to accept. Who told you this? Who told you this? Ibrahim, in that age, with Ismail, building the sacred house, and still they are saying, oh Allah, accept from us. We have some people, they might build a small masjid. A small masjid. What we call it, musalla. Small masjid. And they start feeling arrogance that we built something. We did something. And Allah has to accept. And we have to credit, to take the credit the rest of our life just because we built a small masjid like this. They don't feel the humbleness. Ibrahim and Ismail, they are building the sacred house, but still they are showing the humbleness to Allah. They are raising their hands, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Oh Allah, accept from us. And let me ask you something. If Allah didn't accept from Ibrahim and Ismail, from whom Allah will accept? This is Ibrahim al-Khalil and his son Ismail. For sure, inshallah, Allah will accept from Ibrahim and Ismail. But this is the ibadah. This is the heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the du'as of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This is the story how they built the house of Allah. At that time, after Ibrahim built the house, Allah gave him another command. Ya Ibrahim, أذن في الناس بالحج. Give the call of Hajj. invite people to come for Hajj. Ibrahim at that time, he looked around him. Which people? You mean Allah? No one is here. No one living here. So how can I call them? So he doesn't have speaker system. He doesn't have cell phones. He cannot post this on Facebook. He doesn't have any kind of communication. Just Allah told him, give the call. Invite them. We have many narrations, but let me go to make it so short, that he went to As-Safa. He climbed over the mountain of As-Safa. And he said, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ O people, إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَنَى بَيْتًا فَحُجُّوهُ Now Allah has a sacred house, and he wants you to come to do Hajj. So he was alone. He was alone. But he has the trust. They believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He believed in Allah that many people afterwards, they will come answering the call of Ibrahim. And alhamdulillah, in 2019, we are standing here in the United States of America to speak about the dua of Ibrahim long time ago. And we have some of our brothers and sisters in the community. Some of them already went to Mecca to perform Hajj. And some of them, inshallah, will go during this week to perform Hajj. This is the answer of the call of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Many years ago, until now, alhamdulillah, millions and millions of people are going every year to perform Hajj. This is the ni'mah of Allah. So I know that alhamdulillah, most of you wish to do Hajj. You wish to do Hajj. And maybe if some of you didn't go for Hajj or even Umrah according to his ability, please, there is no excuse not to go for Hajj. There is no excuse if you have the ability, the physical and the financial one, you must go for Hajj. It is one of the pillars of deen. Don't delay it. Don't say, I'm still young, I need to spend time. I will go when I finish my work, when I go for the retirement. At that time, I will go for Hajj. You cannot guarantee it. You might die. And Allah will ask you, my servant, I gave you everything. I gave you money. I gave you power. I gave you energy. So why you didn't go for Hajj? Why you didn't obey me? So it's one of the pillars of deen. It's like salah. It's like siyam. So if you have the ability, don't hesitate. Don't wait. Go for Hajj, inshallah, directly. And if you went before, or you have the emotion towards this, make a dua to Allah. And don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah, that you will go again and again and again, inshallah. So let's make dua to Allah to grant us Hajj in the next year, inshallah. Let's make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower all of us with His mercy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us to perform Hajj. Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us, all of us, the bounties and the blessings of drinking from the water of Zamzam. Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather all of us on the day of Arafah, on the mountain of Arafah, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower all of us with His mercy. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us the intercession of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَلِيَّ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ قُومُوا إِلَى صَلَاتِكُمْ يَرْحَمْكُمُ اللَّهُ